Hi, do you know what is the biggest mistake people do in sales? Do you know why the rich becomes richer and poor becomes poorer? Watch this video till the end because I'm going to share something very different this time. Hi, today's topic is never big in sales. Never big in sales. I started my career in sales from 1998. In fact, I was working for a government organization. Along with that, on a part-time basis, I have joined some network marketing company since 1998. I am into sales, so you can just know how many years I've been there. And with all my sales experience, what I found out is I've seen many people begging in sales, and that's the biggest mistake people do in sales. Just imagine, you see a person begging on the road. Do you want to give him more or less? Obviously you'll give less. Even if you feel pity on the person, you will not give more, just want to give him something so that he'll be happy, correct? But at the same time, you spend a lot of money unnecessarily on items which you never use. You purchased it because there was a sale, maybe some 50% offer or 70% offer or some special sale was happening, and you just purchased the item and dumped it in your cupboard, correct? It's of no use. In fact, when I go to some of my banks, I've seen the staff over there or seen the manager coming in, irritating me by pushing some insurance products and saying that, sir, we have to complete some target, so please do something so that, you know, I can reach my target. So please please recommend also some more people so that I can reach my target. When you meet a person like that, what happens? It irritates us. Correct? In fact, many times I avoid going to the bank just not to meet them. But my question is, do I require an insurance? Yes. Do I require a higher interest on my savings? Yes. Do I require a pension plan? Yes. Do I require a medical cover? Yes. Do I require a life cover? Yes. But still, I don't want to buy when they are pushing me something, or when they are begging to me. Correct? The same thing happens in a network marketing company. People join network marketing companies and start to reach out to their friends and relatives by begging. Correct? Some may even join, not because they like the product or they like the service, just because you irritated them. Because of irritation, they just join. And you may give them big plans, like saying that, okay, there's a big opportunity there and you can make a lot of money, the product is good, blah blah blah, all that. They may join, but they will not do business. Why? Because they joined because of irritation. And later they may blame you, saying that, I didn't make any money. Why? Because they don't know what is the product, they don't know what is the business plan. This is a mistake. This is not just in sales or selling a product or service. This is even in life. Never beg to anyone for anything. In fact, I want to share my testimony. In 2004, after me leaving the government job, 6 months I was literally struggling and I didn't get a job. And after 6 months, in fact, my wife said, Stanley, we have little rice, little dal or ration for some 10 days max, and after that we are completely finished. We don't have anything at home. And that's the time I had an interview with a Singapore company wherein I'm meeting my MD. So the entry was going on, and at the end the final question comes in, like, what's the expectation? Just imagine, if this particular job I don't have, I don't know after 10 days what will happen, because I have no money in my bank and no ration in my home. But with a lot of confidence, I asked 5 times more than my government job salary. 5 times more. And when I said that, my MD was shocked. She was a lady from Singapore. And she said, "That's too much." I was literally shaking inside, but outside I didn't show off. And I was saying that, no, that's my value. Then that should be my salary. And after some negotiation, she just reduced 2,000 rupees. Just 2,000 rupees. Just imagine the other way. If it have said my MD saying that, okay, see, I left my job 6 months before, and for 6 months I don't have a job, and right now I'm literally struggling. There is no money in my bank, and there is no ration in my home. Do you think my MD would have given me 5 times more my salary? Or she would have accepted that? She would have just paid me little more than my previous job. Correct? Never ever beg. We have to understand that nobody is doing a favor by buying your product or service. In fact, they are in need of your product or service. So that's the reason they buy your product. And their money, what they're paying, is for the product or service, and it's not for you. So never beg. Speak with authority and speak with confidence. At the same time, need not to be rude or speak with a lot of pride. Be humble, be gentle, be polite, but not begging. As I keep saying, everything is energy. So when you're begging for something, what's your mindset? What's your energy? Your energy is negative. And what do you attract? You attract negative. That's the reason many people are still struggling, because they have been begging in their life. Have you heard this phrase? Rich becomes richer, poor becomes poorer. Just giving an example of a jeweler selling jewels. Have you seen a jeweler begging to you? When you go and buy some jewels from them, have you ever seen them begging? No, in turn we start bargaining with them, requesting them and begging them and saying that, why don't you reduce it, blah, 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 all that. But at the end, he says, no, if you want to buy it, or just leave it. Correct? He speaks with a lot of confidence, with a lot of authority. And that's where it's a mindset change. So that's the reason why rich becomes richer and the poor becomes poorer. Because it's a mindset change. And that's a program which we do, because many things are conditioned deeper in our subconscious mind. And when talking about sales, many people have a misconception that sales means just selling a product or a commodity. Sorry. Even if you want to be a CEO, top CEO of a company, you need to know how to sell. Because how to sell your ideas, how to sell your thoughts, how to make people work under you effectively. In fact, I got many calls from people saying that, can you train my salespeople? Can you train my staff? Which I say is, I never do that. I train top people. I train the leader. I train the person who is heading the organization. You know why? Because if you really want to head a company, if you really want to head a business, you need to know how to sell. And that's my program, which we train on how to train your mind to sell big, deeper at the subconscious mind. And that's my program. If you're serious to make a difference in your life, my numbers are flashing here. Please do call me and I'll be there to help you. As I keep saying, this particular program is completely online. You can be any part of the world and can reach me out and I'll be there to help you. Again, Wilfred Stanley signing off from Rapid Mind Power. Bye. Thank you. Have a great day.